my name is Kathy Rittmaster. I'm a physical therapist. And today I want to talk to you in depth about the Rift and Pacer, and specifically with a person who presents with a significant kyphosis. The first thing I want you to do is to actually get into a pacer yourself so that you can feel what these adjustments might look like and feel like for the individual that you're working with. So once you get into a pacer yourself, what I'd like you to do is just to kind of feel what it feels like for you to be in a position where your shoulders are forward, your head is down. A lot of times a person who has a kyphosis also tends to sacral sit, so they are in a posterior pelvic tilt. So a lot of times they might be in this position. A lot of times their chin is down, or their hips are back, their legs are forward, so that it is really difficult to step. And their head is down so they can't engage with their environment. So what I'd like you to start with is to really think about the position of their pelvis. I don't think that to start with that we can do a whole lot to change that posterior pelvic tilt that they have. So we're gonna allow for that. If you have an MPS on your pacer, how you can do that is I'm gonna have you bring their pelvis forward. You could also change the tilt of it so that they're back, so they have that posterior pelvic tilt, or to have them at neutral. Being at neutral might be too much for them, but when they're back here, they tend to get a lot of pressure on their sacrum. So just be cognizant of that. Be looking for some nonverbal cues for an individual who is nonverbal of how comfortable that is. So first the pelvis. So you can make that adjustment. I want you to be cognizant of the height of your pacer frame so that it is at their hip level. And then to adjust the pelvis, you are gonna go ahead and push the hips forward. And you're gonna do that by pushing the little button that is underneath the seat. Right now, my seat is flat, but you can also push the button that is kind of flush with the handle, and that will change your tilt. It's a little bit tricky when you're in it yourself. So I'm gonna drop mine back. So right now, my seat is tilted back, so it allows me to be in that posterior pelvic tilt. So what that does is when you allow that posterior pelvic tilt, you can really focus on opening up that chest. If you put them in an anterior pelvic tilt and open up their chest, it might just be too much at one time. So bring their hips forward, be thinking about the hip corral in that position to support them the best. Also be thinking about how this pad behind their pelvis is positioned so that if they have a pelvic obliquity, that you're either helping them compensating for that or that you're correcting that, whatever is needed for that individual to be the most functional. So I'm gonna go ahead and strap that buckle on. So once you have this foundation positioned, it's a lot easier to make adjustments to the chest. You can also be using the pelvic support and the hip positioner instead of the MPS. And what you can do to achieve that position is to actually slide the front of the straps up closer to the arm prompts. You can change the angle by tightening on either one, by tightening or lowering the back straps so that you're putting them more into a tilt so that the front of the prompt is up higher than the back. So play around with any of these seats to see what is most comfortable for the individual that you are working with. So once you have that position figured out, what I want you to do, because you're still gonna be in this position where you're dropped forward, so what I would like you to do is to actually bring the chest prompt back. So hips are good, chest prompt needs to go back. So what you're gonna need to do is change the position of the chest prompt on the frame and just slide it back. So as you loosen those knobs up, you're sliding the chest back, allowing the pelvis to be in this posterior pelvic tilt. And then once you slide the chest back, you're actually opening up their chest some. So when you tighten up the chest prompt, or you have those straps on the back, what I would like you to do is to make the back of the chest prompt really loose. So what that does, it allows the person to drop back. Because I also would like you, so as you can see, the angle can be changed by turning these knobs right here. So as I open up the back, and I can actually tilt this chest prompt up, and I'm gonna tighten them. So now I'm back, my chest is up, and what that does is it opens up the chest so it's a little bit easier for them to breathe. It opens up their chest so that they can lift their head up a little bit better. So they're here. Sometimes my students are still like right here. So what I have to do is try to open this up. There's a couple of different ways that I can do that. First, I'm gonna really try to get my arms in a better position. Because if my arms are in a better position, so if my arms, I may wanna be here, but if I can get my arms up here, what I can do is really push with my arms and use extension, active extension, to open up the chest, lifting up the head. So in order to get my arms in a good position, I'm gonna wanna slide my arm prompts back on the frame. On the dynamic pacer, this crossbar in the front makes it a little bit harder to move it an infinite amount of space on the frame. So you can either put it in front of this crossbar or behind it. I still find that in front of the crossbar is still a good position. As you can see, I'm gonna want my L bar facing in or facing out. I would start with it facing in, and you can either have the bracket on the outside of the frame or the inside of the frame, depending on how large the person is that you're working with. Ideally, you would want them here, close to the inside. So if you can have them on the inside of the frame and it's comfortable for them, try that. But if not, you can have it on the outside of the frame and have this L bar tilting in. The importance of the L bar being either in or out is so that it can slide on the grooves and go up or down rather than side to side if the bar is facing forward or back. So because I have my L bar facing in, I can change the angle of the arm prompt. So this might need to be raised up by pushing the button. Go ahead and slide the arm prompt on here. I'm gonna raise it up by loosening the knob and pushing straight up. If you have this flipped around, there's less space to be moving it up and down, so play around with that adjustment on the arm prompt. I'm gonna go ahead and take this strap here, put it through the loop, and tighten it so it's just touching the Velcro. And now what I can do is just slide my elbow in right there on that prompt. Adjust the handle so that my hand is right on there. My elbow is supported. You may or may not need that strap. But what you can do is have the arms right here. So even if they're forward a little bit, they can work on some active trunk and head extension to lift up and engage with their environment more. And as they become more comfortable in this position, you can play around with the position of the chest prompt on the frame as they progress. You can play around with the angle of the pelvis, and you can play around with the position of the pelvis on the frame as they become, have more, you can play around with that position of the pelvis as they progress and get stronger at their trunk. So maybe they don't need their pelvis as far forward and with as much posterior pelvic tilt. So play around with that, feel what it feels like on yourself, put your individual in the pacer, and look at making adjustments one thing at a time to make them more comfortable. One other thing that you may want to try is this rainbow technique. So what I do is I take a towel and I roll it up. At first I fold it in half, and then I roll it up, and I make a rainbow with it. And then I'm gonna loosen up my chest prompt. And what this does, and I'm just gonna push it right in the front of their trunk. What this does is for that individual who has really poor head control, and their head is down on their chin, is on their chest or on the chest prompt, what this does is it allows me to rest my chin on the towel roll, so I'm here, and I only have to lift this much, and it's a lot easier for them to get their head upright. You might also want to consider using a neck collar, but if you don't have one of those available, or if it's too much support, you can decrease the support by pushing this down more so that they have to work a little bit harder. It's just a really nice and easy, simple little way that you can help give them support and then also reduce that support as they get stronger. Well, I hope this helps you get your individual in a better position. Please feel free to make some comments on the videos, and hopefully that will help us kind of determine the next step for the videos that we make for Rifton. Thank you so much for your time in watching these, and I hope they are helpful to you. Take care.